Dear students, in our last lecture, we had discussed about the nature, benefits, and importance of organizing along with its process. In our today's lecture, we are going to discuss about authority and responsibility. As we have already seen in our last lecture, in the definitions given by various authors about organizing, like one of the objective of the management is to establish a sound organizational structure, and to do this effective effectively, the authority and responsibility relationship should be created, who will be accountable to whom, who are the superior and subordinates, who can give orders, who has to follow the orders, all those things should be clear. So whenever authority is used, responsibility ensues with it, and authority is the legal right, we can say, to give the command, order or instruction and compel the subordinates to do a certain act. Whereas responsibility is the outcome of authority, it entails the obligation of the subordinate who has been assigned the duty or by his superior. There is some basic difference between this authority and responsibility. If we talk about the meaning, the power or authority inherent to a particular job or position to give orders, enforce rules, makes decision and obtain conformity is called authority. Duty or obligation to undertake and complete a task satisfactorily or successfully assigned by the senior or established by one's own commitment is called responsibility. Authority, if we say authority refers to the legal right of the manager to give orders and expect obedience from subordinate, whereas on the other hand, responsibility is the corollary means it results from the authority. The position of an individual in an organization actually determines his or her authority. It means the higher the position of a person in the corporate ladder, the more is the authority. As against it, the superior subordinate relationship forms the basis for responsibility. Then comes the task of a manager. While authority is delegated by the superiors to subordinates, responsibility is assumed, that is inherent to the task assigned. If we see this authority requires need the ability to give orders and instructions, whereas responsibility demands the ability of compliance or obedience to follow the orders. Authority flow from upward to the downward, whereas the responsibility flows from low level to upper level. The purpose of authority is to take decisions and execute them, whereas the purpose of responsibility aims at executing duties assigned by the superior. Authority is inherent with the position, and so it continues for a longer period of time. Unlikely, responsibility gets over as soon as the task is finished. There is one more term, which is accountability. It means giving explanations for any variance in the actual performance from the expectation set. Accountability cannot be delegated. For example, if A is given a task with sufficient authority and A delegates this task to B and ask him to ensure that task is done well. Responsibility rests with B, but accountability still rests with A. The top level management actually is most accountable. Being accountable means being innovative, as the person will think beyond his scope of the job. I would make it more clear with a small example. A mom gives a task to his son to her son to bring a packet of bread with sufficient authority. That is, mom gives 30 rupees, that is authority, to the son and ask him to bring a packet of bread. The son was feeling lazy and he delegates his task to his sister. So ask the sister to ensure that that she brings the bread. Now, actually, if you see, the responsibility of bringing bread now lies with sister, but accountability still rests with the son, because the son had been assigned the task with sufficient authority by the superior, that was mom. So though he had delegated the responsibility to his sister, but still the accountability rests with the son only. The top level management, as I mentioned earlier, is most accountable, because being accountable means like they have to be innovative, as the person will think beyond his scope of job. So accountability, if we say in short, the meaning of accountability is being answerable for the end result. It means if mom has given me a particular task, I am answerable to the mom for the completion of the task. Now, for achieving delegation, a manager actually has to work in a system and has to perform a few steps. Few steps means like following are the three steps which a manager has to perform for achieving the delegation if he is delegating his task. So it is like assignment of duties. It means the delegator has to actually, the delegator first tries to define the task and duties to the subordinate, and he also has to define the result expected from the subordinate. It means if a manager is assigning some task to the subordinate, he has to define the task. Also, he has to define what he or she is expecting from the subordinate as a result. Then he must give the grant the authority to the subordinate. Without sufficient authority, actually the accomplishment of a particular task is disturbed or interrupted, because the decision making gets slower in the absence of proper authority. Then comes creating responsibility and accountability. When manager is delegating a particular task to his subordinates, he must clearly define or must clearly create the responsibility and the accountability. It means for a particular piece of work, who will be the responsible person and who will be accountable to complete that particular task. Then if we see this relationship between authority and responsibility, if you see this authority and responsibility is very much this connected. Like authority, as we have discussed, that authority is the right of a superior to give orders and instructions to his subordinates to get the things done, and responsibility means the duties assigned to a person at the time of delegation of authority. Now, responsibility also denotes the obligation of the subordinate to perform the duty to the best of his ability. Actually, it arises from the superior subordinate relationship only. Like, authority can be delegated, but responsibility cannot be delegated. Authority moves downward. A superior can always share his authority with his subordinates, but he cannot delegate the responsibility or obligation to perform his duty. Whereas if we see, responsibility is owed to one's superior, like no subordinate can avoid his responsibility by delegating some authority to his subordinate. Like, I am a manager, I am responsible for certain tasks to be completed, and I just delegate a partial responsibility to my subordinate. So, like, here, like, the subordinates cannot avoid their responsibility. I will be responsible for the accomplishment of that bunch of tasks, though I am delegating this partial task to my subordinate. Now, when I delegate this task, I also delegate some authority. So, I have delegated the authority. Now, the subordinate whom I have assigned the task, according to me, he is responsible for the completion of that. But the ultimate accountability or responsibility lies with me as a manager, who has been given sufficient resources to complete a particular bunch of tasks. Accountability always moves upward, and so it cannot be delegated. Accountability cannot be delegated. Authority and responsibility are closely related. So, for the completion of a particular task, if the manager is sharing the responsibility, he also shares little authority with the subordinates. There should be a parity. Actually, if you see, there should be a parity between the two, like authority and responsibility. A subordinate will be answerable for the authority delegated to him, and not beyond that. So, this is about the relationship between authority and responsibility. Effective organizing depends on the mastery of several important concepts. Like, these concepts are of comes from Henry Fayol principles. Work specialization, means like it is a division of work. When employees are specialized, output can increase because they become increasingly skilled and efficient. Then the chain of command is there, like who will be passing the orders and who will be following the orders. Then authority, like managers must have the authority to give orders, but they must also keep in mind that with authority comes responsibility also. Then delegation, it means manager alone cannot do everything, so he has to delegate the task among the subordinates. And also span of control. Span of control is very important. Like the manager must be in a position to keep a close watch on the things happening, and if any deviation comes, he must have the controlling system. And centralization versus decentralization. Actually, if we see, the centralization means this principle actually refers to how close employees are to the decision making process. So it is important to aim for an appropriate balance in the organization. And many of these concepts are, if we see, based upon the principles developed by Henry Fayol, the 14 principles which he has developed. So these are the very important concepts in an organization